Our 8-figure company creates between 100 and 200 Loom videos every single day, and these are 12 shortcuts you probably haven't heard of that makes that possible. Number one, there's nothing that'll slow you down more when you're creating Loom videos than having to go in after you shoot the Loom videos and edit it. Whether somebody walks in, something pops up on your screen, or you mess up what you were saying, it's kind of a pain in the butt to wait until after you shoot the video and then find that spot and try to edit it. What a lot of you don't realize is that during a Loom video, if you click Control Shift A, you can actually pause the Loom recording, take care of whatever distraction just popped up, and then do it one more time to play it again. And then do Control Shift A one more time to resume the recording. Number two is Loom's selective screen recording. A lot of the videos that we record on Loom are for employees and for our clients. And there's some things that I don't want them to see while I'm recording, either because it's sensitive information or it will distract them from what I'm trying to talk about. So what I like to do, especially if you have a wider monitor, is you can actually select the area of the screen that you want to record. And then I pull up my notes or my script or that information I didn't want to share on the side that's outside of that screen. So that way the person that's watching the video will only see what I want them to see while I have everything on my screen to make the best video possible. Number three, using Loom videos for standard operating procedures. I talked about it a moment ago, but a lot of the Loom videos that I create as a CEO of our company is for standard operating procedures, essentially how-to guides for our different employees. And the benefit of Loom is that I don't have to always type out word for word every single thing that I want somebody to do for me. Instead, typically what I'll do is I'll just do the thing while I'm having Loom recording me do it, and then I can send it over to the person or just save it inside of our employee guidebook so that they can reference it at a later date. If the thing I'm trying to train this employee on is a little bit more complicated, what I'll do a lot of times is I'll do 5 to 10 days of me doing that Loom recording, let's say me managing our ads online, and then I'll have that employee send me 5 to 10 days of them managing the ads through the Loom recordings. And that way, even though the person lives on the other side of the world, I can make sure we're both on the same page as far as what I'm expecting on managing ads, and I can give feedback without having to get up at weird times in the day. And if that person ever left or we fired that person from the company, I have all of those videos that I can simply give to the next person and really speed up their learning process. Number four is connecting your external camera to Loom. This tip is in particular to the business owners and content creators who really want to up the look or up the brand presence of the Loom videos that they're doing. What'll happen by default is a lot of people make Loom videos using their profile photo or using a grainy webcam photo that came with their laptop computer. But a lot of people don't realize with a simple cam link connection between your camera and your computer, you can actually use your 4K external camera like the one that I have right now inside your Loom videos. One of our favorite ways to use Loom is actually in our sales process. So typically I'm totally removed from the sales process, but if we have somebody that's on the 1-yard line and they just need that extra nudge to come over, one of my salesperson will ask me to shoot them a Loom and send it over to them, essentially answering any of their questions and trying to get them to pull the trigger. And so what I'll typically do, because I'm traveling most of the time, is I will pull out my phone, which also becomes a little bit more of an authentic video, and I'll use a Loom app to shoot a video straight from my phone, and I'll get the link, and then I can just text it right over to that prospect without having to get my computer and open everything up there. Number six is using Loom's drawing and annotation tools. Sometimes when I'm using Loom and I'm having difficulty illustrating a certain topic, I'll use Loom's drawing tool to actually draw it in the middle of the video, whether I'm trying to show someone what a funnel should look like, if I'm trying to break down the math for somebody, or if I'm just trying to highlight specific aspects of the screen recording, using that tool makes it so much easier. Number seven is using Loom's feature to edit out filler words. We've all probably taken speech classes when we were younger and our moms told us not to say or stutter so much, but in reality, if you're filming as much content as we are, it's probably gonna happen. And so instead of trying to force people not to do it, what we like to use is Loom's filler word removal tool, which can actually remove out those words both in the audio and in the text transcripts of your video. After you've recorded your video, click on transcript on the right-hand side and you'll see your filler word words at the top of that transcript. You can then click on remove and choose between text only, text and audio, or do not remove. As a bonus tip, while you're doing that, I recommend selecting make this my default setting so that you don't have to do it every single time. Now, number 8 is only for paid Loom users and only if you use the desktop app. But if you're using Loom on a frequent basis, especially in your business, this is definitely worth it. It's called Loom's click tracking feature. And essentially what it does is it highlights wherever you are clicking on the screen recording. This makes a big deal because I shoot dozens and dozens of screen recordings specifically for YouTube. And one of the pieces of feedback I've gotten is that sometimes it's difficult to see where I'm clicking my mouse during that YouTube video. So Loom came out with this feature so that anywhere that I click my mouse, a big yellow highlighted circle pops up right there that lets the viewer know exactly where they should be clicking their mouse. In order to set this up, open your Loom desktop app, click on the three dots on the top right-hand side, select preferences, and then toggle highlight mouse clicks on. Tip number 9 is so important if you use Loom for business. Please, 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 for the love of God, take an extra 2 or 3 seconds to use a proper naming convention once you've created a Loom video. I can't tell you how many times in the past I've created the same Loom video over and over and over again because after I was done shooting it, I didn't edit the Loom video name, so it was almost impossible for me to find that video in my history. Instead, now every single time I shoot a Loom video, no matter if I'm ever thinking I'm gonna use it again or not, I always follow a specific naming convention that allows me to search for that video and find it again in the future. Properly name your Loom videos. After 6 months or 12 months of creating videos, you could have a huge asset database that you can give your employees, your YouTube viewers, or even your clients that didn't take you but an extra 2 or 3 seconds after you're done shooting the video. Now, number 10 is specifically for business owners who use video almost on a daily basis to serve their clients. In the past 4 years, it's safe to say that I have created literally hundreds of client-facing training videos that are incredibly in-depth. And previously, I used to use software like QuickTime or OBS in order to screen record those trainings. The problem with that is that it was very difficult in order to share those videos with anybody else. For example, I'd have to open up OBS Studio, make sure everything was set up correctly, shoot the video, then download the video, then create a Google Drive folder, then upload the video, then share that with my clients, where now, instead, what I can do is actually just open up the Loom desktop app and start shooting the video in about 5 seconds and then immediately send that link over to our clients or download it directly from Loom and then upload it to maybe a course portal where we can show it there instead. And if you combine that tip with the earlier one of using an external camera on Loom, your clients will have no idea that you're using Loom to shoot these videos and it still maintains your brand presence. Number 11 is to make sure you're using Loom's video editing features. Although I try to do a lot of my videos in one take, there's no doubt that I make mistakes a lot. And previously what I had to do was shoot the video, then download it, then upload it in some editing software, trim out those things, and then upload it back again to some cloud-based software so I could send it to somebody to watch. But now Loom has a feature where after you're done shooting the video, you can actually trim and splice out even specific parts inside of the Loom video you want to remove. Say, for example, if you mess up on a few words or you don't want to include an entire section, you can go inside the side panel of your video after you're done filming it and select split and trim, and then use your keyboard arrows to select the exact milliseconds that you want to trim the video down to, giving it a professional looking finish without having to download or re-upload the video. And my final Loom tip, actually the one that I think is the most important and kind of the coolest one, is to use Loom's ability for custom branding. Now, once again, this is only for those that use the paid plan on Loom, but it's only a few dollars a month and it can have a massive impact on how people perceive your brand. On all of the Loom videos that our company creates, instead of showing Loom's brand and Loom's colors, what we've actually done is replace those with our logo and our brand colors. So that way, every single time we send a video to a client or a prospect, it looks like it's almost our own software that we're recording these videos in. In order to do this, what you want to go to is loom.com/settings, or if you're at loom.com, just go down to the gear icon on the bottom and then click on the appearance tab. From there, you can change the video player color to your main brand color, upload your logo to appear at the top of the video share page, and even remove the Made with Loom logos at the bottom of your videos to make it as clean and branded as possible.